everyone. Welcome back to my next video. Today we are going to have a class from Homes on Wheels Alliance at the virtual RTR 2021. And so I think you're going to really enjoy it. And with me is Sue Ann Carlson, the executive director of Homes on Wheels Alliance, who did an awful lot of the work, amazing amount of work, on putting this all together. So, Sue Ann, tell us about a little bit about what's going on here.
So, from January 14th to January 21st, 2021, we have online RTR and women's RTR classes that will be offered on the Homes on Wheels Alliance YouTube channel. But what we're doing is we're taking those and doing a condensed version of them and moving them over to the Cheap RV Living YouTube channel. And that's what you're watching here.
So this is a monetized channel, but all the money that you make by watching the videos, you're gonna make me money by watching the videos, all of that money will be forwarded to, from now on and forever, will be forwarded to Homes on Wheels Alliance. So I'm not making any money on this. It will be a contribution to Homes on Wheels Alliance. Now, because this is a condensed version, there's a whole version on the Homes on Wheels Alliance YouTube channel. And if you go there, you'll see the whole thing, including questions and answers afterwards. So while this is condensed, you can see the whole thing by going to Homes on Wheels Alliance. And how will they find that?
In your YouTube channel search bar, type in Homes on Wheels Alliance, and it will come up.
So once you go to the channel or this channel, Cheap RV Living, there will be a playlist that says RTR, virtual RTR 2021. And so you can see all the classes there in order and see them all at once. So next, we're going to play the video of the class, and I hope you enjoy it and learn a lot from it. And we'll see you at the end of the video.
Welcome to the 11th annual RTR, and this year we have an online RTR. I'm Sue Ann Carlson. I'm the executive director of Homes on Wheels Alliance, otherwise known as HOWA, H-O-W-A, our acronym. And we are the host this year of the RTRs. Our topic today is work camping opportunities. And our speakers today are Linda Mastromonaco and Brian Gifford. Brian is the treasurer of our board of trustees. Brian's been on the road for 11 years, and his rig is a Class C RV. Linda Mastromonaco is in Florida. Her website and YouTube channel is Serene and Simple Life, and I would highly encourage you to go visit those. Check out the description below, and you'll find the links there to go and visit Linda. Linda is currently on the road in an SUV, and she's been on the road for a total of 2.5 years. So with that, Brian, the floor is yours.
I've been on the road 11 years now. I've been in the same motorhome, and I still love it. It's my little house on wheels. I cannot imagine a different lifestyle at this point. To make that all happen, I did need to make a budget and live within my means. That is very, very important. We're going to have another topic about this later on this week about budgeting, but I just want to put my input on that having a cushion of savings is going to help tremendously. Living paycheck to paycheck is extremely difficult. And so if you have a little bit of that cushion, it helps in so many ways. I do not have a remote job. I don't have an internet job. I don't have other sources of income. Work camping is all I do. It's what I do, and it's what I've been doing for 11 years. And it is very sustainable doing this. All right, so some people may be wondering, what is work camping? It is short-term seasonal positions, both part-time and full-time, that are done in exchange for wages and non-monetary compensation. You're working and you're camping. Like, that is the best thing for us nomads out there. Work camping is for people of all ages. These positions do not have age limits. So just kind of keep that in mind. It is a wonderful, wonderful experience. So there are tons of reasons why you may want to work camp. These are the ones that just came to my mind, but everyone has their own reasons for doing this kind of stuff. You can get experience in jobs that you had never done before. You can learn a new skill. You will meet new people, whether that's coworkers, or it could also be locals in the community. You will meet customers. There's just so many connections that you can make. Become part of a local community. Go to the library. You know, go to the restaurants nearby if there are any. There are just so many ways that you can get involved in the local community that that's also a really big benefit of work camping. I love to backpack. I love to hike. And so I go to these beautiful places, work, and then I get to go play in those beautiful areas. And that is one of my favorite things to do. You earn money. I mean, that's huge. That's how we stay on the road. It goes back into the budgeting and savings thing. This is how you can meet those goals is you can work in the summer. You tend to spend less money when you're working because you aren't driving around, you're saving, I guess, money, things like that. A lot of times they offer free or discounted sites. Sometimes you can do it in an exchange for volunteering. So those are the things, the benefits of work camping. I started working for CLM Services. They're a concessionaire of the National Forest Campgrounds. They're in Oregon, Washington, California, in Colorado. It's usually a 3 to 5 month commitment. There are positions for both singles and couples. Usually they include some sort of hookups, not always full hookups. I've been at places where I just had water and sewer. I have solar panels, so I'm not too worried about the electricity. I usually have a better chance of getting some of those more remote jobs, which is what I prefer. You can also do some of these, as I had mentioned before, for volunteering in exchange for a free site. These are typically less hours, so it might be 20 hours a week, whereas I'm working 30, 40 hours a week. The volunteer ones are usually shorter commitment. They're a month. So if your main goal is to travel around more, then you might want to look at some of those volunteering opportunities in exchange for a free site. You can work in a national park. You get employee housing. It's either free or you pay a little bit for it. It comes out of your paycheck. I don't recall. Another unique thing that I've done is I worked for Cirque du Soleil. That was done through a temp agency. Ski resorts, if you have the ability to live in colder climates, oftentimes they have employee housing at the ski resort, so that's another option. And the final thing on this place that I've worked, woofing. There's two different names for it. The acronym stands for several different things. A Worldwide Organization of Organic Farms, or Willing Workers on Organic Farms. Basically, you are volunteering your time in exchange for knowledge, room, and board. The one thing I will say about that is only commit to 2 weeks at first, and then add on as you will, because you may not share the same values as the people that you're working for. These are ones that I haven't necessarily done myself. And so it's something that, you know, you can do your own due diligence and look for these kind of jobs. The first one on the list is Amazon Camper Force. They always hire people for the holidays, usually I think October, November, December. They pay for a campsite, or they pay up to $550, I think is last I heard. It is hard work. It's long hours, hard work. But it's a short commitment time. It's, you know, 2 months, 1 or 2 months. Everybody's heard about the beef harvest. Another great way to make a lot of money in just a 2 or 3 week period of time. But you're on your feet and you're doing 12-hour shifts. And that's usually done in Minnesota, North and South Dakota. So if you are interested in those kind of things, it's a great opportunity. Gate guard is usually for couples. You're at an oil pump and you are just kind of letting trucks in and out. The other ones, we have pumpkin patch, the Christmas trees and firework booths. You know, again, you can find out more information online about those, but they are options out there. RV transporter, another one. All across the country, there are summer camps that are going in. If you like working with kids, then that's a great way to do it. And the last thing on this list, caretaking. Basically, you are house sitting in exchange for a free place to stay. How to find working camping jobs. Of course, I need to start with the Big Tent Show in Quartzsite, Arizona. It's a great way to see dozens of companies hiring for work camping up positions. You will get to talk with them directly, turn in applications. Sometimes you can even get an interview right there on the spot. Their goal is to have all those positions filled by the end of the Big Tent Show. After that, we have temp agencies. If you're in a town or a city, it's a great way just to get some quick gigs, some interesting gigs too. Like, you never know what kind of jobs are going to be offered at those temp agencies. Some of the websites I recommend: CoolWorks, ZipRecruiter, Work Camper News, Wolf USA, Caretaker Gazette. Those are just a few of the ones I've come across. And it's never too late to apply. You know, every year I've worked for working as a campground host, every year we seem like we're short-staffed in the middle of the summer. People just, some people don't make it to the end of the season. And so they're always looking for people, so it's never too late. So my final thoughts, be honest about your needs. If you absolutely need internet, tell the employer about this. Do you need hookups? Be honest with yourself and your employer. It's a perfect pairing of working and camping. We're getting paid to do these fun things. So keep that in mind. And the final thing, do what you love and what you want to learn. That wraps up my part of the presentation. And I would like to introduce you to our next speaker, Linda.
So I'm going to today share with you what I call the best of both worlds. And that has to do with traveling, sightseeing, working and playing all at the same time. January 2019, I went to the big tent. I had my resume in hand. I had no idea what to expect. I picked up a lot of business cards and I wrote notes. Anybody I talked to, I put their name on the back. I just took it all in. After debriefing the first day, I had to go back when it was a little bit more quiet, like 2-3 days later. People I had already talked to, I had a lot of notes, and I started to zero in on what I was interested in and what would work for me. Well, the outcome was that I did get a job. It took about a week. My first job was a camp host position with California Land Management, as Brian has previously mentioned. I have my whole series of my camp host experience on my channel. I just have to share that with you so that you'll be like, what did she do? What kind of work did she have to do? That's all covered, and don't have enough time to go through that all now. Tip number one here is I had a backup plan. Why on earth would I even need a backup plan? And well, I decided that I'd better just have one just in case. If the workload was too much, if I physically couldn't take care of it, I didn't like the weather, I had an infestation of mice. It was an unforeseen time of year with the mice. They had never experienced like this before. And I said, you know what? I've had enough. I cannot take dealing with the mice situation. I felt like I was being overrun by them. And so I called up my backup plan. My backup plan was Ruby's Inn General Store in Utah, right outside of Bryce Canyon National Park. Woo, what a gift. Back to the best of both worlds. I took off down the road 2 weeks, traveling, sightseeing, taking photographs. Some of you know I do also have an online business, and I use photographs on the backgrounds of sayings, say it, display it. Very, very cool. I'm taking my time. I'm regrouping, and I got to Ruby's. Ruby's Inn was a cashier job. I have lots of cashier experience, but you don't need the experience either. And I got to speak with people from all over the world. I mean, we're talking Italy, Australia, everywhere. What a very cool job. Right before that, at the RTR, I was doing some networking, which I think is also a very good thing to do when you're looking for a job. Ask other people, where have you worked? What have you done? And can I use your name and call people up, you know, and say, hey, Stephanie recommended that she loved working for you and was wondering if you're going to be hiring this season. So that would be another tip. I'm going to bunny trail here is make a pros and cons list. Do you need internet? Do you need solar? Do you need to be in a sunny place? Well, when the world went bonkers, I'm like, okay, now what am I going to do? I'm going to fall back on retail. And I called up Walmart. I became a cashier at Walmart. Where am I going to stay? I asked HR, hey, do you think it would be okay if I stayed in your parking lot? I'm doing this full time as a nomad. I'm traveling the country. The HR lady, she loved the idea. She brought it up into, you know, very discreetly with security. And so every night I would leave Walmart, work 10 hours a day from 8 to 7 while it was still hot outside. I just would go out to my SUV, which I call Happy Haven, and I enjoyed myself. And then on the days off, I visited Glacier National Park and different local parks. And I would even hang out at a community college if I didn't feel like going anywhere. So again, the best of both worlds. Enjoyed myself. Now they say never. I thought, you know what? I don't ever want to go back to Walmart again. It's just something that I want other experiences. Well, with the state of the country and everything going on, lo and behold, where do you think I am right now? So I'm now in the system with Walmart. I'm back here working for the rest of my short-term goal. I did the same thing with our HR, although I have a wonderful friend who has allowed me to stay on her property, met her on my channel. It was fantastic. And so I'm just, I'm going through it. And I decided to make it fun. Instead of just doing cashiering, I'm now doing online grocery picking. So you see where this is going. It's not just Amazon for online grocery and stuff. Walmart's competing with them in a big way. And that's what I'm doing. I'm pretty excited about that. And I also have 6 online presences in addition to jobs. Now, Brian said work camping is all he does. You know, I have my online business, Etsy. I'm an Amazon affiliate. I have Teespring and Redbubble, you know, t-shirts, anybody can do that. And I have, of course, my channel. And my biggest recommendation is just to have fun. I have been to stunningly beautiful states, Utah, Washington, Montana. Now I'm in Florida. None of this would have ever happened had I not decided to say yes to working. And lastly, why work if you don't really want to? Like, you know, when I became 62, I thought, oh, I'm never going to have to work again. I am so glad that I did not get on that train because it has helped me with loneliness. I have the freedom. It helps with isolation. The security, the building of security with your savings or a short-term or a long-term goal, your mental, a physical, emotional, spiritual life will be enhanced. And I'm going to leave you with 3 sayings. Fill your life with experiences, not things. Have stories to tell, not stuff to show. Create your own happiness. Today is the day. And nature is cheaper than therapy.
That was some very good teaching. I think you got a lot out of it. But this was a condensed version. So to see the entire thing, including questions and answers, where do they need to go?
You can go to the Homes on Wheels Alliance YouTube channel. In your search bar, just type in Homes on Wheels Alliance and it'll come up.
And once there will be a playlist there of all the RTR videos in their entire length. So there'll be a lot more info there than this condensed version. Well, I hope you got something out of this video. If you did, like us on YouTube, subscribe to the channel, hit that thumbs up button, and we'll talk to you later.